What I'm going to do, I'm going to swear by myself.
Yeah.
You know, you're a bad man when you can swear by yourself.
Amen.
You're a bad man when you ain't got to put your hand on the Bible. I am the Bible.
Come on.
You ain't got to swear by the Word. I am the Word.
Come on here.
He said, I am the way.
Yes, sir.
I am the truth. He ain't looking for truth. He is the truth.
Amen.
The fact that it came out of his mouth means it's true.
Amen.
So the Bible says when he could swear by no William, he swore by himself. Read, sister.
Saying, surely blessing, I will bless thee.
Surely blessing, I will bless you.
And multiplying, I will multiply.
And I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to multiply you.
And so, after he had patiently endured, he obtained the promise. For men verily swear by the greater.
Uh-huh.
And an oath for confirmation
uh-huh.
at the end of all strife.
In other words, if you put it in writing, everything gonna be all right. We were sitting in the office last night talking with a bishop that built a 1,500-seater church. And he said when he got ready to get the man in the building, you know, God will put you in the right place with the right people. Talk to you, drop off some wisdom when you don't know, praise God. And praise our God, he said, let me tell you something. He said, when you get ready, he didn't even know that we're thinking about building. Praise the Lord. But he said, praise our God, hallelujah. When you get ready to build, he said, make sure anybody that's working on your property, make sure they have a contract. Make sure they put it in writing. Yeah, I know we're saved when we're jumping around here. He said, but put it in writing and make them stick to the contract.
Amen.
Amen. He's saying, business be men.
Right.
You know, God know how to put you in the right place with the right people.
That's
you can't swim with, praise God, with folk that's in the same mess you in because they can't help pull you out, praise God.
Amen.
You drowning and I'm drowning, I'm going to get out.
Amen.
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 Amen. You want to know how to get out of some places? Find somebody that got out of them.
Amen.
Wisdom, you're so proud. The Lord don't show me the anointing. Let me tell you something. The anointing give you wisdom and put you in places where you can open up your ears and listen.
Amen.
Some of us so spiritually deep, we stupid, praise God.
Amen.
That's why we keep going around in the same circle over and over again because you ain't listening to that God.
Amen.
You
Amen.
You want to learn how to do something? Go find somebody and have done it.
That's right.
That's right.
Well, I'm waiting on the Lord to teach me. He done put something out there to teach you.
Right.
Sometimes, praise the Lord, our pride won't let us humble ourselves down and say, you know, I just don't know.
I don't know.
Amen.
Surround yourself with it. Do you think when we build this church, I'm going to do it myself? You think I'm going to do it by myself?
Come on.
No, I'm surrounding myself with folks that know what they're doing and know how to do it. Praise, you hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Many times, amen, you can't move forward, praise our God, because you got your hand in everything. You can't have your hand in everything. Sometimes you got to trust the God that and people that you have set up, praise the Lord.
Man.
An overseer is an overseer. You're not a drone worker. We don't put the general in the highest part of the battle. Where he can make my God decisions, praise God.
Amen.
Everybody want to fight. Everybody can't fight. Nobody got to sit back and think about this thing.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God made a promise to me. The reason why you see what you see and God is doing because God has made some promises. And it looked just like those things were not going to come to pass. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
But he said, praise God, my covenant will I not break. Amen. And I'm not going to alter the things that come out of my lips. And I'm going to tell somebody, if God has promised you anything, amen, look for God to do it. Praise God.
Because
your all hell could break out around you. Praise God. And it look like you're going to die before you get the promise. But the devil is a liar. I'm not going to die. Get everything that God has for me.
Amen.
You lay down and die if you want.
That's all.
Man.
I got the victory.
Yes.
I ain't trying to get the victory. I already got it.
Yes.
Oh, you hear what I'm telling you? The Lord is on my side.
Yes.
Man.
When God is on your side, you got to spend time fighting your enemies.
Amen.
You got your problems.
You got to spend time trying to make them believe who you are.
Amen.
All you do is do what God told you to do.
Amen.
You know God will make a believer out of folk.
Yes, he will.
As long as you're trying to make a believer out of them, praise God, you're going to fall.
That's right.
Let me just get this straight. Everybody ain't going to believe you no way.
You got it right.
Amen.
You got it right.
Well, that's pretty good.
Amen.
That's a good preaching right there.
Amen. Go ahead.
Everybody, listen. Everybody ain't gonna believe you.
Amen.
I'm talking about in the church. Everybody ain't gonna believe you.
Amen.
Some of y'all don't believe me right now.
Amen.
Some of you come and look at me every Sunday and you still don't believe me.
Amen.
What you do is let God do the work.
That's right.
And when he does the work, they can say, surely a prophet has been among us. That's all you got to do, praise the Lord. You ain't got to try to make something happen or make people do. Just do what God, do what is in your heart.
Amen.
You got it right.
I come to tell you today that it is a done
deal.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It is.
It is.
It is.
It is.
A done deal. The man of God that they put up to have remarks.
Uh-huh.
Last night he wasn't even,
right,
praying the Lord. He wasn't even gonna say nothing until at least 2 minutes ago. I'll say three words.
Yes.
He said, it's already done.
Amen.
I said, echo what the preacher said on Friday night.
Thank you, Jesus.
I can see the baptism of you ready, but you might have a Sunday. You don't have to have both the temple down in the water every Sunday.
Come on now.
You can get with the Holy Ghost every Sunday.
Thank you, Lord.
I'm opening up my mind because God is doing a new thing.
Amen.
Come on and say it again.
Amen.
That girl is on fire.
Yeah.
Fire is moving by in power.
Yes.
Amen.
God got the right people.
Come on here.
just what? Washing the cars?
I was washing cars.
He was washing the cars.
Yes, sir.
And he told the man that one day I'm going to own this place.
That's right.
Glory to God, he spoke it by faith.
Yes.
You ain't hearing what I'm telling you. Glory to God, you got to speak by faith. Come on, son.
Amen.
Glory to God, you got to speak by faith. He looked at the man, I got it.
It's all right, it's all right.
Go ahead.
Hallelujah. But Lord, you don't know, somebody need to start speaking some stuff.
Come on now.
That's right.
Why are you worried? You must not believe God. Because if God promised you, then you can't die until you get what he said. You can't die until you, my Jesus, no matter how much they wanted to kill, he couldn't die until he gave up the ghost. And then give up. But what are you worried about?
Jesus.
That's some things that God has promised.
Amen.
He's not going, it's a done deal.
Amen.
That's right.
You living holy?
Yes.
You living right?
Yes.
You faithful to God?
Yes.
It's a done deal.
Amen.
I refuse to come to church anymore depressed.
Amen.
I refuse to come to church anymore trying to get attention from folks.
Amen.
They don't need to try to get your attention nowhere. You can't do nothing for me.
Amen.
You can pray and that's all you can do.
Amen.
You got to leave it in the hands of God.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
You got it right.
I refuse to let
right.
The devil steal my joy anymore.
Amen.
God is doing a new thing.
Yes, he is.
As I get ready to go to my seat, God is doing a new thing. We're in a new season of church. We're in a new season of church. And I know folks wanted to go back so much, but it ain't going back. And if you want to be relevant, if you want to be able to touch lives, you've got to move. But God don't change, no, God don't, God heard. You ain't. You got to change. Bible says that the just, amen, shine brighter. Amen? I'm not quoting it just right, but you understand what I'm saying. That they shine brighter. Amen. Glory to God. What does that mean? That means I'm going to know more in the end than I knew in the beginning. And you got to be able, amen, to transform. Mm-hmm. You got to be able to change. I'm not saying be sinful. I'm talking about change. Your ideologies. Your stronghold. The new season. And only the ones that are willing to break forth can move into that new season. Because a lot of folks won't die in the wilderness. But they can't change over. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me today? They got electric cars now. Electric and gasoline. Electric and gasoline.
That's right.
Some of you ain't gonna never drive no gas, no electric car. But what you gonna do when they make all the cars in there?
That's right.
They ain't gonna do it. Oh, it's coming.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. You got to shift.
That's right.
We used to say, don't bring cell phones in the church. No cell phones. And because when they first come out, they didn't have all the applications that they have now. People just letting them ring and all kind of stuff. But the Lord opened up my eyes. And Sister Barbara, I went to Elizabeth City with a preacher. And he asked them to pull out the Bible. And everybody began to pull out their phones. They had the Bible app on their telephone.
Yeah.
They were reading the Bible. They used tablets and iPads and got their Bible. Praise the Lord. If you stuck in the dinosaur age, how are you going to minister to a generation that is moving forward?
Amen.
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 That's right.
Jesus rode a donkey and a camel. But we don't ride those now.
You got it right.
Come on and say amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Right.
You got to be approachable. Some of you think, praise the God, because you hear about running around looking like a Muslim that you dress and hold, and now you just look hot. And folks don't know how to approach you, but they think you want them to, because see, most of them been hurt by some of them sanctified looking folks.
Yeah. You got it right.
No, I'm not telling you don't dress sanctified. I'm trying to tell you, take it out of your clothes and put it really in your heart.
Man.
When it's really in your heart, it'll permeate all throughout you.
Yes, it
will.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Are y'all hearing me?
Amen.
It's a done deal.
Yes, sir.
Done.
Holiness is more than the name on our door.
That's right.
He says, follow peace with all men.
Amen.
And holiness without no man shall see the Lord. In other words, holiness is being able to follow peace.
That's right.
Your dress can be long and your hat can be thin, but if everywhere you go there's confusion, you're not holy. You're not walking in holiness. Take all your earrings off, strip yourself of makeup, but if you are a backbiter and a tailbearer and got hatred, you're not holy. He said, follow peace with all men.
Amen.
Oh, read it for yourself. Read it in the right context. Stop bashing people with the word and read it for yourself and let God clean you up.
Amen.
We need a heart transplant. I better shut up now. Feel like hell when I'm going to hurt. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We got to be relevant. Every time God get ready to take the church to another level, some Pharisee want to come in and kill. The devil ain't gonna kill this next move of God.
Amen.
The religious spirit ain't gonna kill the next move of God.
Amen.
I will rebuke you openly and sit you down so fast your head gonna spin.
Amen.
Before I let you contaminate this new crop that God is sending in.
All right.
You get my drift?
Amen.
We ain't playing those games no more.
Amen.
Y'all understand what I'm saying? We're moving forward.
Amen.
Move forward.
Hallelujah. Reverend, the next time you come, we might have to put seats down the aisle. It ain't going to be joy fest.
That's right.
Is that what I mean?
The church supposed to grow.
Yes.
We're not supposed to be here 20 years and still got the same 5 members.
Yes.
And sometimes it's a trap, because you stay long enough, somebody gonna die and you got to bury it.
Yes.
Amen.
You think, oh, we preach so much truth that day, and nobody know. I felt that way in the beginning until I learned some sense. God didn't send me to preach to the benches and the chairs.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
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 God didn't send me, praise the Lord, to preach amen to a small crowd all the time.
Amen.
The Bible said the spy is not the day of small beginning, but something that starts small ought to grow big.
That's right.
It should grow.
If you don't believe it, listen to this. Forgive me. I'm going to sit down. I promise you. Do you remember the story of the talents?
Yeah.
I believe it's about Matthew 25.
Amen.
You ain't got to go there, but read it in your spare time.
Uh-huh.
The story of the town. These preachers are talking about, well, you know, sometimes you just got to stay weird and be faithful. Some stuff that about the while you don't receive no benefit. Sometimes you just need to shut down. Because God, you miss God. God knows how to increase his work, praise the Lord. We're just trying to do things to be seen. We don't want to be subject to nobody. So we just want to start our own, praise God. Amen. But see, everybody's not meant to be an overseer. Somebody got to follow somebody.
Amen.
Know what the word of God said. He said that there was a certain man that called his servants together, got ready to go on a trip. And when he called them, he gave each one a talent. He gave one talent, one two, and the other five. Come on, say amen. And he said in one gospel, he says, occupy until I come. Come on, say amen. Now the one that received 5, the Bible says he went and traded it and gained other 5. The other one that had 2, he traded and he got 2. Let me show you where Church of God's Romans is right now. The one had 1. Took that one, and the Bible said he gave it to them according to their several abilities. See, ability means something. Everybody can't do something. But God will give you something on your level. He gave him one, he wrapped it up in a napkin, buried it, hid it in the earth. Thought God was going to be pleased. I'm going to be just like I was when Jesus saved me. No, baby. If you just like you was when he first saved you, and baby, you might hear the part from me. He don't want you to stay like you was. He wants you to be better.
Amen.
He wants you to grow in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He come back. Praise the Lord. And the Bible says he come to reckon with them. And he said, praise the Lord, you know, let's settle the deal. The one that had 5 said, Lord, you entrusted me with 5. I got 5 more.
That's right.
He said, well done.
Amen.
Thou good and faithful servant. I'm going to make you rule over 10 cities.
Come on.
Lord have mercy.
Jesus.
To the one, praise the Lord, they had 2. He traded God. He said, well done. Now he's saying, well done. Now I'm wondering what the one that done hid the talent, I wonder what he's thinking when they getting the well done. He didn't come with nothing that he grew. He come with mouth and excuses like we do.
Yeah.
Lord, don't nobody want to hear me when I preach. Don't nobody want to hear this gospel. Folks don't want to walk with the Lord. They just, they ain't. He said, Lord. He said, I knew you was a hard man. Reaping where you didn't sow. And I was afraid. Look at somebody and say, don't you be afraid.
Don't you be afraid.
Fear will stop you from moving forward in the plan of God.
Amen.
God has not given us the spirit of fear,
Amen. But
of love, power, and a what?
Sound.
He said, I was afraid. and I hid it. He said, "No, Lord, hear this is thine." He looked at me. He said, "You wicked and slothful servant. You knew I was hard. Knew I reaped where I didn't sow and gathered where I hadn't straw. You should have at least put my money to the use. You at least should have put it in the bank. So at least I kind of got some interest off of it."
Amen.
You know what he said? He said, "Take his and give it to the one with ten."
That's right. Amen.
Look at the one. Look at the one. Lord, praise God that had ten. Somebody said, "Well, Lord, he has ten." Yeah, that's right. Because the one that have shall be given. And to him that have not, even what he does have, going to be taken away. These preachers that ain't trying to grow the house of God, you ain't trying to go out and get souls to come. You said God entrusted you with people. And you're not trying to grow the church. God says, "When I come back and reckon with you, you ain't going to hear, 'Amen, praise the Lord, well done.' You're going to hear, 'Depart from me.'"
Man.
He said, "Then shall the kingdom of heaven be like." That's what you all you live around. You got one wife, no sweetheart. You don't drink, you don't smoke, but you ain't doing it, don't you? Put this collar on if you ain't going to do the work.
Amen. Amen.
Woe is me if I preach not the gospel. Oh, yeah. Sometimes you got to be courageous in doing what God said. Yes. Sometimes family will turn against you. I'm talking about family.
Yes, man.
People that shed your blood and look like you.
Yes, right.
They didn't call you. God did. And if God called you, sometimes you just got to...
Remember, the Bible said, "Lay aside every weight."
You just got to get used to people not liking you.
That's part of the journey.
As a believer, what has God entrusted you that you're not making multiply? Reckoning time is coming. Reckoning time is coming. What are you doing? Who has been influenced to come to the church because of your life? Reckoning time is coming. What kind of fruit do you have? And is it remaining? Reckoning time is coming. We've been saying so long, we ought to know how to live holy by now.
That's right.
That ain't the fruit that he's talking about.
That's right.
A city set on a hill that cannot be here. Churches are done deep. You hear me, side is a done deal. God spoke it, he ain't gonna alter it. It's a done deal. I'm not worried about what we got to go through. Hallelujah. All I want to do, Lord, let me please you. God took in it because he had the testimony. I please God. I want to please him today. I want him to be satisfied with my life.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I want to know, praise the Lord, that, Lord, you're well pleased with what I'm doing.
Amen.
I thank him for how he continues to set this seal of approval. I thank God, but even now I can see the body expanding and growing. I see God doing. Y'all might can't see what I see, but I see some things. Hallelujah. It's only a matter of time, praise the Lord. This stuff is breaking forth.
Amen.
May God bless you today. Heaven smile upon you. Put you to thinking on God's word. Touch somebody and show a neighbor.
Neighbor.
It is.
It is.
A done deal.
A done deal.
In Jesus' name.
Done deal.